how to read a cash flow statement. So, you know, the first step I told you as a best practice is understand your cash flow. So, you know, for that you need to understand how to read a cash flow statement. You may ask your accountant to give you a cash flow statement and not understand it. So, I'll just in the next few minutes tell you how to read a cash flow statement. So, your cash flow statement consists of three parts. One is cash generated from operating activities. What it means is when we are doing business, we are doing sale, we are doing purchases, we are spending money for operations like rent, salary, and then there is a profit which gets generated. And while we do so, our debtors could go up, our accounts receivable, it could go down, the inventory could build up, it could go down. So what is it? That is the sum of what happened with operations. When we did operating activity, whether there was a cash which got generated positively or whether it got generated negatively. There is a sample which comes next. This is from the theoretical part that here you need to know whether we generated enough cash from our operation. Second is investing activities. So this, when we talk about investing activities, we mean whether money has gone into cash flow generating assets, you know. Where is that money gone? When you made money, we want to make money, use the money for right purpose so that that purpose again makes money and then again we make more cash. So, you know, we have to get into a positive vicious cycle that we make profits which get converted into cash flows. These cash flows are invested into further income generating assets which again generate cash flows, and so we have a ballooning effect coming there. So how much of that cash got utilized in investment in investing activities? Now these investing activities are buying a fixed asset, which is like buying machinery, buying office, you know, buying software, buying computers. Or if we are not able to identify those opportunities right now, how much of that has gone into investment of bonds or any other places where we have invested so that either they are investment related to business or that money can be used for further buying fixed asset when they are returned. So, you know, that shows out of the profit how much money got invested there. And if you are selling a property, it shows the inflow there. Or if you are selling an investment, it shows the inflow there. And the last is financing activity, which shows how a business is financed. So, business is either financed by your own capital or by debt. So, it shows that how much borrowing you had to take or from the profit, how much borrowing you could return. So, the intention is that if I had borrowed to do my business, so I need to know that I made profit and I returned my loan. So my loan has come down. So if I as an entrepreneur am able to know that I made 4 crore rupees profit and I could create 2 crores of asset and I could return 2 crores of my loan, that is the best thing and the simplest thing. If somebody can explain to me, I'll be the happy. Which is something that a lot of entrepreneurs still are not able to get because they are so much into their business and they never get the right. So this is a simple cash flow statement, how it looks like. It starts from your operating income, there's a profit of 489,000, and then you add back things which are non-cash or non-recurring. So you add back depreciation, which is non-cash. There is no outgo of money when we show depreciation. Purchase of machinery is an outflow, but depreciation of machinery is not an outflow. So you add back, and when we add it back, all that we see that there is a positive cash flow generated from operating activities of 269,000. Out of that, we sold some equipment, we sold some land, and we bought some new equipment. So we had another 136,000 getting generated from our investing activities because we had inflow of money coming from investment, equipment and land. So our profit got added. Now out of this, what did we do with this money? We paid dividend to the shareholders 90,000 rupees, and we had some bonds or debts that we had, and we paid them off 290,000 rupees. And so in the year, we still retain 115,000. So if somebody can tell the story of your business in such a simple manner that your whole effort in the year is translated into 270,000 rupees of profit, which went to buy, plus you had some fixed asset sale, plus you repaid some bonds, you got some dividend for the shareholder, and then you still added 115,000. In opening, you already had 319,000, so now you are sitting on a cash buffer of 435,000. So, you know, in a simple terms, you understand this cash flows. It's important that everybody of you all go back, ask your accounts team to give you a cash flow statement in a manner which is prepared that you understand, and then you understand your business well.
BLL.
So glad to be here.
BLL.